Welcome to this week's webisode of The Better Half. I'm Kendra D. St. Aubin, and this is Katie Hartley, and we're going to take a look back at what's been going on this week.
That's right, Kendra. A big weekend in the NFL. Kendra, who do you think we will see in the Super Bowl?
Well, I do think we are going to kind of see an East Coast Super Bowl. I think we're going to have the Patriots and the Giants. That's my prediction. I know it's going to be tough for the Giants to go on the road and win across the country, but I think they're going to do it.
And I actually agree with you on this one. I think it's going to be the Patriots and the Giants as well. The Patriots, I mean, this is not breaking news that Tom Brady is a great quarterback. But I like the way that the Giants are shaping up. It's hard for me as a Cowboys fan to say that. But the Giants' defense has been playing exceptionally well, especially in the last five games. They've held their opponents to an average of 12 points per game, which I think will be the reason that they defeat the San Francisco 49ers.
Well, and they went on the road in Green Bay and won in a really tough place to play, and now they're going into a pretty good climate, so I think that's going to, they're just on a roll right now, and I think the 49ers are struggling. But what about, who would you want to see win if you're a Cardinals fan? And we both talked about this. Do you want your division to do well? Is it important for them to do well? Or are you completely rooting against the 49ers if you're a Cardinals fan?
Hell no, I don't want the 49ers to do well. Are you kidding me? If I'm a Cardinals fan, I hate the 49ers. And there's no way I'm cheering for them, divisional or not. I don't care. I don't want them to win. I just compare it to being a Cowboys fan. I hate the Giants. I'm always going to hate the Giants. I'm never going to cheer for them to win. How about you?
I'm the same way. I could not be happier when the Packers lost last weekend. I was so ecstatic, and I would never want to see the Bears win either. The Lions, maybe a little bit of help, you know, since they've been bad for so long. But no, I mean, being a Vikings fan, I absolutely would not want the Packers to get anywhere near the Super Bowl again. It was bad enough last year.
Well, a team that hasn't been doing very much winning lately, unfortunately, is our own Phoenix Suns. They're in the middle of a road trip right now, and it is not shaping up too well. The question is now, should we give up on this team for seeing them in the playoffs?
I'm not completely giving up on them, but I am not nearly as optimistic as I was early on. I think it's going to take some, you know, bad play on the other team's part to help the Suns out and possibly sneak in the playoffs as the eighth spot. But otherwise, I mean, that the game this week, I mean, that this road trip and the Bulls, I almost vomited watching the game.
God, that's rough, Kendra.
Oh my gosh, it was terrible. They had a whole day off in Chicago, and the Bulls are playing on the second night of a back-to-back, and no Derrick Rose. I mean, if you can't beat the Bulls then you're screwed.
Well,
and it doesn't get any easier.
I'm not ready to give up just yet either. I still think the Suns have plenty of time to turn it around. They're not the worst
yet
in their conference just yet. They just don't have a money guy. You know, they haven't figured out. They still haven't found their rhythm just yet. But I still think they can turn it around. I have hope.
Do you want them to turn it around, though? If you're a Suns fan, do you want them to tank it now and try to build for the future get those draft picks?
I want to see them turn it around. I want to see exciting basketball with the abbreviated season. I think it's important that we see this team win some games.
I feel bad for Steve Nash. I'm just going to throw that out there at this point.
Well, somebody else to feel bad for is the Colts ex-head coach, Jim Caldwell. I thought a disastrous way to make this announcement with the owner. Kendra, what do you think of this situation?
Well, I think Jim Irsay, I'm a little confused about his whole Twitter, you know, what he does, and, you know, directing people to Colts.com and saying, hey, go on there for breaking news shortly, and then you fire the head coach. I mean, I just don't know if that's a head coach, if that's the owner's job. To tweet that kind of stuff out. I mean, maybe if it's the beat reporter or somebody else in the organization, but I think it's odd coming from the owner. I think you're supposed to be in a different spot, and maybe he's on a bit of a power trip, you know, firing the Polians and then now Caldwell. And I mean, is he trying to push Manning out the door?
I think he's being a complete narcissist and taking that kind of role in this sort of situation when guys like Peyton Manning are involved. I think it's just a tragedy. I think it's so sad for the organization. They have gotten a lot of respect over the last couple of years. And for Jim Irsay to do something like that, I just think is terrible. And shame on you for doing that and posting it on Twitter. And if you've ever seen his Twitter page, it's shameful, the picture that you have up there.
He's not lacking confidence,
no,
I don't think.
No, he certainly is not.
And I mean, we love it for our job because it gives us something to talk about.
Sure.
Whether it's on the radio or doing this broadcast. I mean, it's great for us as media members, but it's just an overall opinion. I just don't think it's a real great thing for an owner to do.
Yeah, not so much. I'm shaking my finger at him. And shaking my finger at John Elway for saying that Tim Tebow has earned the starting quarterback role at the Denver Broncos. Do you agree?
I do, because Brady Quinn is the other option right now. So I do think that he's earned the spot. He's earned the right to be the starting quarterback because he has proven that he can win. Now, they kind of tanked towards the end of the season there. So I think going into next season, you have to say he is the starter and it is his job to lose. But there's still going to be a competition there.
So he's earned it because he beat the Pittsburgh Steelers or he got thrashed by the Patriots.
Whoa.
Which one?
Well, you know, the one people are going to remember is the Patriots because it's most recent. Yep. But you don't think he's earned the starting spot? It's not his job to lose right now?
I don't think so. Not just yet. I think it was
you
sort
are
of the perfect
Tebow
storm for
lover. And
I
you're
do
coming
love,
out with this?
I do love Tim Tebow, but I just don't think he's a starting quarterback just yet.
Maybe he should be running back or fullback or something.
I mean, think I want to see him start as a running back
bit,
next
yeah.
year.
It's a possibility.
Think about that, John Elway. Well, we're out of time this week on The Better Half. She's Kendra D. St. Aubin. You can follow her on Twitter at Kendra620. You can follow me at FunKatie620. We'll be back next week with another webisode of The Better Half.